Okay, let's now have Attorney Barbo back. Attorney Barbo, maayong buntag.
Maayong buntag. Yes, good morning. Maupay nga kulup.
All right, sir, let me get your reactions first on a number of items that developed in the past 2 days. First, the president himself declaring he will run for vice president with Senator Bongo as presidential candidate. You've previously said this is shameful. Now that he has publicly said so, what do you make of it?
Well, sometimes you cannot trust. Not only sometimes, perhaps more often than not, you cannot trust the word of the president. He has been flipping from one statement to another. And I do not like, or we do not like, that kind of a national leader. He should be forthright with what he thinks this is or that is the direction that he's taking. And he's taking us to a merry-go-round. I think that's about unfair for a public servant who is supposed to be the number one servant of the people because we pay him with our taxpayers.
And then, Attorney Barbo, we have this development that the president supposedly said that if his daughter, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, runs for president, Senator Bongo is out. He too will not run out of delicadeza. So now, is the president really serious about running for vice president and serving the country for another 6 years? Or is he more concerned that another Duterte or an ally will be in place once he steps down from office?
Well, this only serves my previous statement that you really cannot trust the word of the president. Now, but let us be clear about this. The president is bent on staying in power. Why? It's not because of the national interest for purposes of national development. I think it's because of some basic fundamental personal reasons. One of which is that he would like to protect himself and wriggle away from very, very serious allegations which are now filed and on record at the International Criminal Court. So perhaps he thinks that while in power, the long arm of the law cannot catch up with him because he's in power. But this is a different ball game altogether. Perhaps he has his way of thinking that because most of the members of the judiciary are his appointees, he thinks that he can get away with the wrongdoing. That is their purpose. So it's unclear. In fact, it muddles the issue whether it's going to be Bongo or Sara. What is clear is it's the Gong Duterte, because he is going to use his daughter, his own daughter, he is going to use his own acolyte, Bongo, and he can dictate on them. And so it's really unfair, because assuming, for the sake of argument, that Bongo and Duterte, meaning the father, will run and both of them win, you can be almost sure that the back door is open for the president to be president again in contravention of the very clear provisions of the Constitution. It can also be the other way around, assuming it's going to be Sara and the president wins as vice president. The same thing will happen, perhaps not perhaps immediately, but perhaps in the middle part or early part of the term, we will have that arrangement because they are fearful of their own freedom and their liberty. They are definitely going to answer some serious criminal, not only administrative, but serious criminal charges in the Philippine courts as well as in the International Criminal Court. I think that's the purpose of Duterte running. He is not concerned about the destiny of this country. And all the while we thought, when I was the campaign manager of President Duterte in summer, I was with him, and he would always say, well, we're going to make this country move forward. And I was leading the crowd in clapping their hands. But, you know, like I had been saying, nabudol-budol kami because imbis na pasasalamatan yung mga bumuto sa kanya, ano ginawa niya? Ininsulto niya pa. Ano sabi niya? Kayo, mga bumoto sa akin, kayo mga estupido at mga bobo. Ba't kayo maniniwala sa akin na pupunta ako sa West Philippine Sea mag-JGSK? Hindi naman ako marunong lumangoy eh. You know, things like this. And that is why, number one, the word and the credibility of the president is subterranean. It's not only zero, it's subterranean already. Nobody can just believe him at face value. I question his credibility. And that is why he does not deserve to be in the PDP-Laban, because the PDP-Laban is a creation of good, not only good-natured, but idealistic people who founded, you know, the founders of the PDP-Laban were people, not really only politicians, but people who were good in. People who were determined and inspired not only to fight the brutal and rapacious dictatorship of Marcos, but to implement certain basic fundamental programs, changes, and reforms. In fact, I was telling people whenever we campaign, you let's go for Duterte because he's the guy with balls and he is going to institute and pursue certain reforms and changes which could be revolutionary or even radical for as long as these changes and reforms are democratic and peaceful. That's why we're the genuine PDP-Laban members are regretting. We had this kind of president. Nabudol-budol, I don't know. Kung may mga kaibigan ka, Mike, na nabudol-budol din, na-scam, naniwala kami. Nagtiwala kami because here is the guy na pa-kipot-kipot pa. Ayaw niya kunwari. Just like what he's doing now, pa-kipot-kipot, including Sarah. Nagpapakipot-kipot pa because the idea is kung ikaw ay nagpapakipot, lalo kang pipilitin. And asking the people to clamor. I-clamor naman kayo ah. Mag-clamor kayo na gusto niyo ako. That's what they are doing. And our president is a tactician, political tactician. He knows how to go about his way in politics. And that is why number one is question his credibility. I question his credibility. I'm not saying about his sanity, his political sanity. I'm questioning his political credibility. And I think very, very un-PDP-Laban life, yung kaniyang attitude.
Attorney Barbo, yes. Let me just go back to your party's decision to actually endorse President Duterte, to invite him to the party when he was not a member of PDP-Laban. You said you are regretting that decision, but what was the basis? Were you enamored by his supposed vision, but did you not check his track record in Davao, for example? You know his human rights record. You also know that he belongs to a dynasty. When he was running for president, you have a son and daughter running for various positions in Davao. Is that not a red flag for you? Why did you support him in the first place?
You're correct, but let me set the picture right. I am informed that President Duterte became a member of PDP-Laban. At the time, perhaps by virtue of just raising his hand or taking allegiance, he was not. He was not a member. But when he filed his certificate of candidacy, he put there as member of PDP-Laban. I have always been saying that the operative act is not your raising of left hand. We raise our left hand as when we take our oath. It's not the operative act. It's merely ceremonial. The operative act to become a member is for you to undergo what we call BMS, Basic membership seminar, you pay your dues, and then you do some rights and obligations of the PDP-Laban. Remember, he was never, during his term as a mayor and as a congressman, he never was a member, a regular member of the PDP-Laban because of those.
So why did you choose him? Why did you choose him?
Well, we were told he was a PDP-Laban member, and we thought very well at the time, and perhaps that is our error, but we thought he was a natural PDP-Laban because he was brandishing, he was saying, and I heard him right when he said, I believe in PDP-Laban, especially because of federalism. And we are the only political party, Mike, that provides or endorses federalism in our constitution and bylaws of the PDP-Laban. And we thought, here is the guy who can bring some necessary changes and reforms. And we were even saying that this is perhaps the opportunity to do away with the political dynasty because he's a PDP-Laban. And about political turncoatism, we can perhaps utilize his political willpower to pursue some ideals of the PDP-Laban. But all the rest is now history.
All right.
We were used. We were used. In All fact, right. overused.
Let me go to the present, because that's 2016. You now have Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte claiming she was given two letters from the president himself. One explaining why she should support the Go Duterte tandem, the other suggesting that she should take Go as her vice president. Now, what do you make of this? Are you seeing some form of resistance from Mayor Sara, or is this all for a show? And why does the president insist on installing Go either as president or vice president?
I am not really familiar with the mental calisthenics of the father-daughter tandem, but all along we have been saying that Go is merely a creation of the president, which means he can dispense or dispose with him at any given time he so likes. Now, what about Sara? Will Sara get Bongo? That is another question. I'm not familiar with the mental framework of Sara. But I am informed that Bongo is one of those people that the daughter personally dislikes. Because I think Bongo, well, this might be just a rumor, but since Bongo is deeply and personally aligned with the president, in the quarrel in the family, of course, Sara is with the mother, and Bongo sides, of course, with Anilit. And so I think you can just imagine the mechanics of a family. Well, let's not go into that, but these are purely...
I wouldn't want to go into rumors and the family disputes, Attorney Barbo, but is your position similar to that of Ron Monsayak, the executive director for the Pacquiao faction? He's saying that, you know, the Go Duterte tandem is really just a smokescreen for Sara Duterte, the real candidate. And if that's the case, why is there a need for a smokescreen at this point? We are just more than a month away from filing of certificates of candidacies. So why not just declare if she is running or if they're endorsing Sara Duterte, why not declare it now?
Well, like I said earlier, Mike, the president is a tactician. We do not know really his works, his mental works. But there is one aspect of tactician, even in military, is that if you can confuse the enemy, that's good for you. Confuse the enemy and then attack. Well, but Well, like I said earlier, the president cannot be forthright. Right from the start, he would say, I am not running. As a matter of fact, I remember Nene Pimentel. I talked with him and I said, Sir Nene Pimentel, I think we have a problem. This guy may be, that was before, even before the filing of the certificate of candidacy. And he was saying so many things in his statements, which were desultory, without direction, and disorganized. And I would say, Sir Nene, I think our candidate might be self-destructing this early. Can you say something or tell him or, you know, advise him or let somebody close to him advise him? And Nene Pimentel immediately told me, and he said, I will always remember what he said. Lutz, he does not listen. He was referring to Duterte. Now what will happen, because he has his own mind, the more he confuses his enemy, even his friends, sometimes you have to confuse your enemy, even your friends, to confuse the enemy. So that, you know, there is a semblance of authenticity, because even your closest friends are confused, so it's easier to confuse the enemy. But I think the guy himself is getting confused. So he cannot be forthright by saying, I am not really running. I am supporting Sarah, my daughter. Bongo is just my, you know, my acolyte. He's just my caregiver sometimes. And therefore, at any given time, at a click of my finger, he's out. So it's going to be Sarah, my daughter. Now, I think we are in a bind, Mike. We have a problem. We have a president that confuses his own people, that does not tell us straight what it is like to lead. I have always been saying that in the PDP-Laban, we are trained. If you're a leader, you have to lead the way, show the way, and go all out of the way. But here, he goes this way, that way, that way, everywhere. As if he's going everywhere, he's going somewhere, ending up nowhere. That's your problem. Yeah.
Attorney Barbo, now let me just go to the implications of these developments on your party. Because Mayor Sara Duterte has called your party a sitcom, and in disarray, you have two factions already seeking recognition from the COMELEC. What then becomes of PDP-Laban, especially if the Go Duterte tandem decides not to run to give way to Mayor Sara?
That's speculative, yet there's going to be a hearing. If she describes the party as a sitcom, assuming it becomes so. But who caused it? Who dismembered the PDP-Laban? Who broke a very good alternative political party that is not conventional, that is not usual, that is not the same political party? We have always believed that we are the alternative political party because the party espouses different ideals and concepts of governance. And we believe that the sole purpose of a political party is to help frame a good government that would pursue a correct direction of development, not for personal aggrandizement, like they are doing now. They are just utilizing, they are trying to cling as if, you know, Mike, I will have to be honest with you, parang nasusuka ba ako na gagamitin nila yung PDP-Laban na mga trapo naman sila. That is why I think I was the first to use the word hijack. They are hijacking the political party. Yung iba naman, ang sabi naman, Governor Barbo, hindi naman hijacking. Baka karnapping lang, kinakarnap lang. Well, pati na yung mga drivers, kinakarnap din nila.
Actually, Barbo, so what lessons can we learn from, you know, this situation, this, you know, this whole relationship between the president and PDP-Laban, especially for parties right now who are wooing future presidential candidates, or in fact, those who will run for May 2022? What should parties remember with the example or with this, you know, the relationship between PDP-Laban and President Duterte?
Well, there are many lessons to learn about all this. Number one, perhaps, is that we need to have a respectable political party system in this country. And that is why we were hoping that the committee to review, a constitutional committee to review the 1987 constitution, would even perhaps look into how political parties should be regarded. Because in other political parties, in other sitting, in other governments, political parties are even funded by the government, so that there is less prospect of corrupting donors, people who would contribute, and perhaps in the buy and sell system of politics. Another lesson, perhaps, is that right from the start, siguro kilatis na yung mga tao. I am a party to the blame worthy. I ask people to vote for Duterte, hoping that he would be, the true PDP-Laban-like leader. And we should know that the president has a way of going into smoke screens. How would you take it? Sasabihan ka, hindi naman ako talaga tatakbo. That was 2016. May edad na ako, matanda na ako, at saka may sakit ako, hindi na ako tatakbo. Yung pala, nagpapakipot. And some of us were asking him, takbo, we need you. Siguro yun ang ibig niya sabihin, kayo ay nauto kayo, naabodol-bodol, kayo ay scam. Ganun naman ang politika eh. Scamming lang naman ang politika. Budol-budol lang naman eh. Lokohan lang eh. Palitan lang ng boto. But we need to change the whole corrupt system of governance and politics in this country. That's why I joined PDP-Laban. Kaya ayaw kong umalis sa PDP-Laban 1980s pa. Hanggang naging 3 terms ako as governor, I never wanted to change political party.
Attorney Barbo, sorry to cut you if we don't have that much time, but lastly and very quickly, should another Duterte be elected to serve either as president or vice president and serve in the next 6 years in the Philippines?
Never again. Never again. All right. Not any Duterte or yung kaparis ang ugali. Mahusay lang mambola.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for your thoughts this morning,
thank you, Mike.
Attorney Lutgardo Barbo.
Thank you, Mike. Bye-bye. Good morning. Mabuti nagkaroon dito ng signal.
All right, sir. We appreciate you joining us despite the difficulty.